I got a new one. Here and here. Hello, I'm Bart Taylor.
And I'm Matt Arndt.
We'd like to take a few minutes and discuss the typical electrical systems found in a Keystone RV. The electrical system is a combination of 12 volt DC, direct current, and 120 volt AC, alternating current, system. In simpler terms, the 12 volt system is what an automobile uses, and the 120 volt system is what your house uses.
Now let's talk about the 120 volt system. Hey, where are you going? That guy, I tell ya. The 120 volt system is powered by plugging the shoreline cord into an outside power source or running the generator if you got one. Once connected, you can operate the roof air conditioner, microwave, and use the 120 volt receptacles throughout the unit. As an option, some water heaters use 120 volt power in addition to propane. Your unit is equipped with a converter or battery charger that only operates when the shoreline cord is plugged in to an appropriate 120 volt power source or a running generator. This converts 120 volts to 12 volts to operate your 12 volt features in your unit and sends a low amp charge to your battery. The breaker panel for the 120 volt breakers is located inside the unit next to the 12 volt fuse panel. The 120 volt system comes in either one of two configurations, 30 or 50 amp. 30 amp service is the most common that is used in RVs and available in campgrounds. Many items in your RV operate on 12 volt power and do not require much energy. 120 volt appliances, such as the air conditioner, microwave, 120 volt element on the water heater, and plug-in appliances, such as a toaster or coffee maker, require a substantial amount of energy. For vehicles equipped with 30 amp service, it is recommended to only run one major 120 volt appliance at a time to avoid tripping breakers. It might help to think of it this way. If you start with 30 pennies, representing the 30 amps available, take away 7 on average for the converter, which typically draws 5 to 13 amps, depending on the battery level and the 12 volt load. Then take away up to 15 for the air conditioner and 3 for the refrigerator. There are about 5 pennies left for all remaining 120 volt devices in the unit. That's just not enough to run the water heater, the microwave, or any other appliances such as a toaster, coffee maker, hair dryer on electric. Now let's talk about 50 amp, 120 volt power. Vehicles equipped with 50 amp service can run 2 air conditioners in addition to a few other appliances at the same time when plugged into a 50 amp outlet. That's because on 50 amp service, there are 2 6-gauge conductors that supply power to your RV, as opposed to 1 10-gauge conductor for 30 amp service. Adapters are available to allow you to plug your 30 amp cord into a standard wall receptacle, which is not GFCI protected. Adapters are also available to allow you to plug your 50 amp cord into 30 amp service, or a standard wall receptacle, which is not GFCI protected. When plugged into a standard 15 amp wall outlet, do not run any 120 volt appliances. The adapter is only intended to run the converter to supply 12 volt power for interior lights and to charge the battery. If you are using a 30 amp adapter and are plugged into 30 amp service, you can run one appliance at a time. Be mindful of energy consumption while using adapters as they increase resistance and tripping of breakers. If it is necessary to use an extension cord to extend your RV shoreline cord to the available campground electrical outlet, the correct size of the extension cord must be utilized. For example, 30 amp service, you need a 30 amp 10 gauge extension cord not to exceed 50 feet. Adapters and reducers are not to be used when using an extension cord, and do not plug multiple extension cords together. This can cause operational problems with the RV and increase the risk of fire, property damage, and personal injury, and we don't want that. Your local Keystone dealer can assist you in obtaining the proper extension cord for your needs. If you should happen to blow a fuse or trip a breaker, always identify the cause and correct it. Never install a fuse or breaker with a higher rating than specified for that circuit. This increases your risk of fire, property damage, and personal injury as well.
For further questions regarding fuses, breakers, and electrical power, please refer to your Keystone Owner's Manual, your dealer, or feel free to contact us at 866-425-4369.
For more videos about operating, maintaining, and repairing your RV, you can visit the owners section of KeystoneRV.com, download the My Keystone mobile app, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thanks for watching. Oh,